good morning. My name is Roseanne Guerinni. I made the 86th Women's Crucio at St. Pius X in Zealand's Grove. I sat at the table of St. Joseph in Makita, and I'm a member of Sacred Heart of Jesus Parish in Lewistown. So I'm going to be talking today about Chapter 9 in this book, Whom Shall I Send? Discern the Will of God, by Father Frank S. Stelman. And the title of the chapter is entitled Spiritual and Political Power. Power, what is it? The dictionary defines it as the capacity or ability to direct or influence the behavior of others or the course of events. The exercise of power can change what goes on around us, for good or for bad. In the scripture readings at the beginning of the chapter, John chapter 18, 33 to 37, we see Pontius Pilate saying to Jesus, "Surely you know I have power to release you, and I have power to crucify you. One outcome is good, the other very bad." And Jesus' reply was, "You would have no power over me at all if it had not been given you from above." We as Christians are taught that all power and authority comes from God. As the title of chapter 9 suggests, we're dealing with two different kinds of power on earth. Political power, which Pilate was exercising by virtue of his position as the prefect of the Roman province of Judea. And spiritual power, which was and is the power of Jesus' kingdom, and which he modeled for us in his life, lived as a servant leader. When we lived our Crucio weekend, we filled out that inventory sheet, which showed clearly where our time was going, and hopefully opened our eyes to how much time we were giving to God versus other things in our life. Now, as leaders in the Crucio movement, we need to take another kind of inventory. Are we seeking political power? Are we allowing ambition to divert us from our true purpose? Are we willing to abandon ourselves to the grace of God working through us? If you will know the answers to these questions a little better, after we review the four key differences between political power and spiritual power that Father Salmani points out in this chapter. The first is that political power is vested in the position a person holds, whereas spiritual power is vested in the person. Political power is used to coerce others to change their behaviors. The manager of a company can hire, fire, reward, or punish you. Any person that holds that position can do the same. Power doesn't come from the person, it comes from the position. Political power is also used to persuade others, like when politicians attempt to win you to their side by arguments, promises, and gimmicks. Spiritual power has nothing to do with coercing someone or relying on gimmicks to persuade them. And apostolic efforts using these techniques will almost always fail. Spiritual power influences others through the integrity of the person. It is a gift from God and relies on His grace to achieve its purpose through kindness, love, wisdom, and humor, but most importantly, through humility. The saints are a great example of this kind of power, like St. Teresa of Calcutta. She lived amongst the poorest of the poor, wore a simple sari, yet was known all over the world because of the love she gave to the poor in her dying moments. St. Paul was under house arrest, but still evangelizing, exhorting, and encouraging the Christian communities. Jesus had the universe at his disposal, but he did not use it for ambition or earthly gains. He did not save himself when he could, but humbled himself, even to death. The second point is that political power is temporary. Because this power relies on position, money, or status, if you lose your status, you lose your power. Think Bernie Madoff. Spiritual power, because it comes from the integrity of the person, cannot be taken away. The book gives the example of Jimmy Carter, former president of the United States. When he left the White House and went back to his peanut farm in Georgia, he maintained the same quiet leadership building houses for habitat for humanity as he had been the leader of the free world. He was the same kind and generous person in office or not. The third point is that political power is something to be achieved or gained, as opposed to spiritual power, which is a way of living that comes from our innermost self. If you join the army as a career, your goal is to attain the highest rank possible. If you teach at a university, you want to become renowned in your field and have tenure. Your ambition drives you to seek the most power or status you can gain. Spiritual power, on the other hand, is attained by emptying oneself of ambition, growing in holiness through prayer, study, and action, and becoming a servant for the Lord. The fourth and final point is that political power is all about getting control and keeping it. Spiritual power comes from surrendering control and recognizing that God is in charge. We all know how difficult that can be at times to put into practice, and I think we are going to be tested in this area in the months to come in the Cusio movement. And as it states in the book, any group in the church will be most successful when directed by spiritual power and not by political power. Those who will be leaders in the Cusio movement should aspire to be servants first. Forget about being popular or pleasing everyone, which anyone who has been a leader knows pleasing everyone will not happen. Instead, dedicate yourself to doing God's work. Forget about being in control. That doesn't mean there should be no rules or order. As Father Salvani states, the absence of order is anarchy. Anarchy means everyone is in control, and that is the rule of the devil. We need order, vision, and direction, with the guiding power always being God. So to summarize this chapter, spiritual power and leadership is what's needed in the Cusio movement. Spiritual power does not come from position or status, but it comes from the integrity of the person. Because of that, spiritual power cannot be taken away, nor does it change because it changes in circumstances. We cannot achieve or gain spiritual power through ambition. It comes to us as grace from God as we progress in our conversion and deepen our relationship with Him. Spiritual power comes from recognizing that God is in control, not us. So let us go forward in humility to love and serve and build up the kingdom of God. Take a look.